Hello everyone, welcome to Dan Draw Design. I'm Dan. Today we'll be taking a test drive of Autodesk Sketchbook on Android devices, specifically the smaller device such as my Note 8. Autodesk recently brought out an update for their Sketchbook app, version 4, releasing certain features and tools that many Sketchbook users have been wanting for a little while now. So let's dig in and have a look at some of the new things that they've got to offer. With Sketchbook 4.0, they've improved the rendering engine, enabling us to be able to go up to the size of 100 megapixels on a canvas, which is 10,000 by 10,000 pixels. However, when going those larger size canvases, you'll find that the layers will be restricted to the amount of pixels used in the canvas. So at that maximum 100 megapixel canvas, you'll only be able to use 4 layers. This is not necessarily a bad thing in my experience. Many programmers do the exact same thing. This is just so that the user gets a better experience and doesn't have to deal with as many crashes when working on those larger canvases. Sketchbook's user interface has also changed to the better. They've included marking menu, giving you quick access to flip canvas, last color, color picker, transparent color, and last brush. As simple as clicking and tapping, or you can actually swipe in the direction once you put your pen down on that little dot that's at the bottom of the screen. The corner shortcuts are now fully customizable to various different actions set in the preferences. When double tapping in those corners, you can also activate the shortcuts that way. Being that it's on the Note 8, it misses out on a lot of great features that the tablet version of this application has to offer. So quickly, I'll just grab out one of my older tablets just so I can show you an example of what the interface looks like on a large device. Instantly, you'll see that the top toolbar has an instant access to all the menu items, whereas in the Note 8, you'd have to go through the menu system to find those. On the left toolbar, you've got the brushes, and you've also able to adjust with those little bars on the side, the opacity and the size of your brush. The last icon in the top toolbar is the rapid UI toggle on and off. When activated, you're greeted with a minimal look where you get the full size of your canvas at your fingertips. On the left-hand side, you'll see a paddle which you can scroll up and down, quickly accessing the three most used menu systems in the application, such as your brush library, color wheel, and your layers menu. On the left-hand side of that paddle, you'll find that there's two little bars. Top one is to change the size of your brush, and the bottom one is to change the opacity of your brush. One thing also worth mentioning is that in tablets, you're able to change the toolbar from left to right, so a left-hand user can use the tablet as well. With the tablet, you're able to go landscape and portrait mode, where in the Note 8, unfortunately, you're stuck with portrait mode. This is, however, not the only thing that the Note 8 misses out on, or small devices. On the right-hand side toolbar where the layers are, there is a quick access for customize swatches palettes where you can drag across colors that you wish to use in your drawing and save them there for quick access whilst you're working on your art. The brush menu on the left hand side, you automatically lose that anyway, but you're also in the tablet version, you're able to customize that quick access toolbar. Much like the palette, you just simply drag across the tool that you want in that bar. So being a Note 8, unfortunately, you're going to be missing out on a lot of those core features and enhancements that Autodesk has done to the tablet versions, which is a real shame because I'd like to have been able to have that somehow implemented in a smaller device on Android. We'll move forward and show you some of the other features that have been included in the Note 8. So with version 4, you now get 170 default brushes, which are fully customizable. They've included and added new textures to those brushes and other brushes as well, so you're able to add those textures as customization. However, you're not able to upload any of your own textures, which means you're pretty limited to only the selection that's available on the actual app. I'm not sure if it's new or not, but I did notice when I looked into the brush types, it seems to have more blend modes for the brushes. I'm not sure if that was there before. So now you're able to apply those layer blends to your brushes separately. When using an inkbrush for, say, doing line work or something like that, I found that the new Predictive Stroke, which is added into this latest update, rather nice to use. What it does, it seems to automatically predict if you're trying to do a line. So once you do that line and it's reasonably straight, or depending on what you set the Predictive Stroke level at, it will detect that and actually draw the line straight. Just much like if you were to draw a square, it will actually recognize that you're trying to draw a square and draw the square for you. Much same as a rectangle, triangle, circle, and ellipse. So, I mean, they're quite handy features if that's something that you're looking for. In the layers menu, they've now added the lock layer, so you're able to protect that layer, which prevents you from destroying the layer by accident. Whilst being in the layer section as well, they've added two more settings, such as the color adjustment. So you've got the HSL adjustment, which makes your layer warmer or cooler or darker or lighter. And then you've also got the color balance, which is also quite handy when you want to change the color of that particular layer and change the hues and saturations and midtones and shadows and highlights and all that sort of jazz. They've now added the full copy color library into the actual program, also including the complementary colors, so taking out a lot of the guesswork for you. Also, when I was looking through the actual application, I noticed that they've got this setting in next to where all the settings are with the two arrows that look like a random icon. So I went in there to have a little play around to see how that works, and I was quite surprised that it actually acts as a random color picker. So every time you do an action with that particular brush, it will create a separate color depending on the selections of what you actually choose in the settings. So you can choose the hue, saturation, and luminance of the actual colors, varying the actual range that it would select. So I quickly did a little test to show you how it all worked. They've included this new three-finger gesture, which is four separate customizable shortcuts which can be accessed in the preferences. When using the three-finger gesture, you can swipe up, down, left, and right, choosing either one of the shortcuts that you've assigned. If you go into the transform tools, they've now included a new tool set called Distort, which enables you to be able to change the proportions of your sketch, fix perspective issues, and it also helps with foreshortening. I end up trying the distort tool with some text to see how it would perform with doing that. I found that it worked wonderfully. It was actually quite a good experience. I think it's a great addition to the actual application itself. They have changed a couple of things in the guides area or rulers. With the ruler now, you're able to draw on both sides of that ruler, and it also corresponds with readouts of the angle that you have the ruler set as. With the ellipse tool, new manipulators have been included into the actual guide. So you're able to change it to suit your specific needs. This was one of the things that many sketchbook users wanted to actually be able to do. And it also does the same thing in readouts of the corresponding degrees and angles that the ellipses have. They've now added a new tool in the symmetry toolset, which enables you to use a radial symmetry tool up to 16 times. So with the 16 times replicating of the same line that you would do initially. This is really good for mandala artists and people that do radial patterns. So that pretty much wraps up all the new features that are available on Autodesk's Sketchbook 4.0. So now I'll start talking about how it performed whilst I was having a look through all the different features and seeing how it all ran at higher canvas sizes and such. Well, I didn't go without a hitch. There was a few issues that I came about. Occasionally I would have fairly bad lag, especially when it comes to airbrush tools and any other brush that has high textures or anything that's that would usually be intensive on the system, especially at higher canvases. This is completely normal, but it was worth a mention anyway. When using the radial symmetry tool and the guides such as the ruler or the ellipse tool, I occasionally came across this bug. The ruler or the symmetry lines weren't actually displaying on the screen and everything was flashing and causing some really strange things going on inside the application. So it was most definitely a bug that was happening. When I actually went to go research about the bug, apparently it's a known issue with this specific model of Note 8 that I've got here. And apparently this is something that happens. It causes it to crash and all that sort of thing. They're aware of the problem and it looks like that they will be fixing it. So hopefully in the next update that would be all fixed. I didn't do exactly a stress test on this particular application because they don't have unlimited layers, etc. But I did end up doing a canvas at 10,000 by 10,000 using all four layers. I did find it very laggy when I did that. Also, when I used the fill tool at one time, it actually caused me to close out of the entire phone and causing the phone to reboot. So that's part of that issue that's been mentioned in the forums of being a bug with this Note 8 model. Besides that, everything else seemed to work really well. I found that if you went under 4,000 by 4,000 pixels on the canvas size, I found that there was very minimal lag, if any. It was mostly when it was at the larger canvas size, which is sort of expected with certain brushes. To get the most use out of Sketchbook, you're going to have to pay a little amount to be able to use all the pro tools. You can pay a one-off payment of $4.99 US to purchase the pro tools separately, or you can pay $4.99 per month for a subscription base, which then entitles you to use all the platforms of Mac, PC, iOS and Android. You can also pay yearly, which is $29.99 US dollars. I end up purchasing a subscription because I wanted to test this out on iOS and a few other devices. So I was able to pick that up in the Black Friday and Cyber Monday sales, which enabled me to pick it up for 50% of that price. For me, it was worthwhile trying it out. You can pick up the free version, but it will limit you to quite a fair bit. If you want to try out all the features and all the Pro Tools that are available through the subscription or via purchasing the Pro Tools, I recommend trying out the 7-day trial that is available. So you can give it a go, have a play around with all the features on your device and see if you like it. So overall, what did I think of Autodesk Sketchbook on the Note 8? After trying it on various other platforms such as the iOS and a larger tablet on the Android, I feel like it's missing some of the best features that has to offer on this particular update. It was a missed opportunity with the rapid UI being so good in the larger platforms of iOS and Android. But there could have been something added to the smaller devices such as the Note 8. Even a simple toolbar allowing the user to customize it so that they're able to quickly access tools and brushes that they use quite regularly. That would have been sufficient, or at least something there, instead of just hiding the top toolbar. That would have been super. Besides having the performance issues that I encountered during my use of the application, which I'm sure will be only rectified in future updates, I would have really liked to have been able to do this video in landscape mode. Unfortunately, being on a small device, it doesn't allow you to switch. I could have recorded the video in landscape mode, but the user interface wouldn't have been able to rotate with it. So it would have all been on a 45 degree angle. I think Autodesk Sketchbook is a great application as a whole. It just needs that fine tuning, especially on the small devices like the Note 8. If this is something you want to test out on your Android device, definitely download it and do the 7-day trial. If it's something you like, fantastic. Leave it down in the comments below. I'd love to hear how you thought of the application, what you liked and what you didn't like. If there's an app that you want me to check out on the Android device, definitely leave it in the comments as well. As always, thank you very much for taking the time to watch my video. If you like it, make sure you leave a thumbs up. If you want to see more of this type of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel. Till next time, see yous later.